Welcome back to Hey Kentucky. Time for another round two matchup in the Hey Kentucky casting call. We are joined by Dwight and Allison. The UK football program recently extended an offer to a 13-year-old lineman. Now, he is 6'6" and 300 pounds, but it's the youngest player ever offered by the University of Kentucky. I'll start with you, Allison. Is it too young? Should there be a minimum age before schools can offer scholarships?
I think it is too young. I mean, he's got 5 years, you know, to still play for college or for high school. I think that 13 seems awfully young. I think it might be okay for them to, you know, come visit him and extend, you know, like some hays. We're interested, but 13 offering, I mean, he doesn't really get to explore other options at that point. If you're 13, that's the only college that's talking to you. I mean, I think you're probably gonna, you know, go there. So I think that, I think it seems a little young. I don't think there's a problem with like maybe saying, hey, you know, we're interested, but he's still got 5 years. I just think it seems awfully young.
Look, it's not the size of the dog in the fight, it's the fight in the dog. And at that age, I think it's a terrible recruiting tactic because you don't know what you're going to get. Mm-hmm. We have a player now that has gotten slack because of his size, and he was, you know, given a scholarship because of his size and his potential. You don't know what they're going to become at that age.
But now, wait a minute, that's a different question, though. You're seeming, Dwight, saying it's stupid for Kentucky to do it. But the question is, should they be banned from doing it?
Well, yes, I think they can go ahead and nix that because it's not a smart technique, and I don't think it's going to benefit them in the long haul to offer a scholarship that young. And I don't think children that young should be thinking that far ahead. They've got so much in front of them.
All right, I got one more question for you all before we go. Employees at a Wisconsin business recently volunteered to have microchips put in them to allow them to buy things at vending machines or at the company store without having to use cash or credit cards. Would either of you, we'll start with you, Dwight, do a microchip to help you pay for things without having to use cards or cash?
Not for a bag of chips, Matt. You run the risk of going through an airport and setting off detectors, and now you're getting cavity searched because you wanted a bag of pretzels quick. That's terrible. No, I wouldn't like that at all. I wouldn't like that not one bit.
I would totally do it. I can't find my wallet 90% of my, I don't know where my keys are. Like, that's so much easier. Just, like, scan me, go. It's fine. I totally am for that. I think, like, in the future, that'll be what we do. Because, like, I don't know where my checkbook is. I have, like, a sweatshirt I wore from school that I haven't paid for, like, a week and a half. I mean, I don't know where anything is half the time. So that's just a convenience. Like, you know, I mean, I don't think it's going to, like, travel up my arm, you know, and, like, you know, make me sick or anything. So I say go for it. Scan me, move on. You know, I can get my gum, my chips, whatever.
Setting
I'm
off
totally
alarms
for it.
And
well,
K-Mart.
It's not like a giant metal thing. I mean, it's like a teeny tiny little micro thingy. I don't think there's, I mean, I'm totally for that. I think that's a super great idea.
I don't need any extra reasons to get frisked.
Well, I mean, it's not a giant, it's an itty bitty little tiny thing. I don't think
that's
it's gonna,
how it starts. Now, if it gives you a hologram out of your arm or something, or if you can, you know, shoot spider webs out of it or something.
Well, it's a little tiny thing that charges
that's
you
how it starts.
Money.
And 10 years later, you're there like Iron Man. John Stark.
Well, no, it's like a
doing all kinds
tiny,
of crap.
You're thinking giant spat wire. No, it's a little itty bitty tiny thing.
All right, I'll stop you all right there. That was really interesting. I feel like both of you were doing like little comedy bits there. I don't know exactly how that worked. What do you got, Chris? What do you think?
Allison, do people mention your voice to you a lot?
All the time.
I feel your pain. I feel your pain. Now, listen, Dwight,
you
were at a disadvantage because if all being equal, your time to speak, you get about 1/16th of the words that Allison says in her time to speak. So, but the benefit is that Allison is able to put together an entire argument, support it, everything, come to a conclusion, thesis, by the time she's finished with, you know, a short statement. You had great thoughts. I mean, I liked when you, my favorite moment of yours, Dwight, was when you went, you know what? No. Like you just definitively said, I'm making this, I'm not going to waffle on it. And you know, Allison as well, I think that you spit out a bunch of words, but they mean something, and you're cohesive about it. You're not just babbling. So,
now, Allison, you're likable, but you get going, and I think you talk too much.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't say that to be mean.
Yeah.
Like, I just think your first 15 seconds of answers are awesome, but you don't need the last 10, and because you kind of repeat what you said in the first 15. But you're extremely likable and et cetera. Now, Dwight, it's odd to me, you strike me as getting nervous, which is weird because you're an actor, and it feels like to me, were you nervous in this?
No, it's from, see, I do stand-up theater,
and
it's a persona that I utilize sometimes. I have that energy sometimes.
So in the third question, I could see that, and I liked the persona. It was almost like you were like, I felt like I was listening to Chris Rock, to be honest with you. But at the beginning, it just struck me as being nervous and not confident. And the one thing about doing this is, whether you know what you're doing or not, act like you do.
That's right.
Right? And so that would be my only issue. But ultimately, it's not my decision. It's the other dude with the funny voice's decision. Are you going with Allison or are you going with Dwight?
I think you guys both did a tremendous job. Dwight, my only issue with you is that sometimes I feel like your cadence is more of a stand-up cadence. Mm. And I don't know that it fits as well when Allison is kind of, you know, rolling on and rolling on, but she is supporting your arguments and bringing a lot of good arguments. For that reason, love you both, but I'm gonna go with Allison.